We want to make it clear. No adults or learners in primary school at LICS will accept bullying of any kind. What is bullying? Pause the video and think. Bullying is when a person or a group of people try to hurt or make another person who has less power feel bad about themselves. It is repeated. It can be verbal, social, or physical.
Verbal: teasing, name-calling, inappropriate comments, threatening to hurt. Social: leaving someone out on purpose, telling other children not to be friends with someone, spreading rumors about someone. Physical: kicking, hitting, pinching, spitting, tripping, pushing, taking or breaking someone's things, make mean or rude hand gestures.
How do you feel when you see someone being bullied? How would you feel if you were being bullied? How would you feel if you were the bully? Why do you think a bully bullies? What is cyberbullying? What should you do if it happens to you or you see it happening to someone else? Cyberbullying. Don't respond. Don't retaliate. Copy it down or screenshot it. Block them online. Report to an adult. Maybe you bullied someone online. You might feel a little braver online than you feel it in school. You might think, I can always delete it. But what you put online can always be found online, whether you delete it or not. Don't say anything online that you wouldn't want your parents or teachers to read or see. You might only make one comment online, but after that, other people can comment too. That equals lots of comments. So that's bullying. Maturity. Knowing what bullying is and what to do about it is part of becoming more mature. Learning. Understanding other people and their feelings is an important part of learning. Growing up. Understanding when our actions and the actions of other people are right or wrong helps us to grow up.
Have you been bullied? Have you seen bullying at LICS? Are you a bully? What should you do? Talk to the duty teacher, your class teacher, your specialist teacher, Ms. Higgs, Ms. Sawyer, or Ms. Barshagen.
When there is bullying, there are bullies, reinforcers, bystanders, victims, and defenders. Bullies. Now we all know what bullies are. Reinforcers. These people support the bullying and being mean. Bystanders. Bystanders see the bullying but do not do anything about it. Victims. Victims are those people who are bullied. Defenders. Defenders are the children who try to support the victim.
Stand up to bullying. Choose respect.
Let's protect every member of our LICS community.
Primary learners, Ms. Barshagen here. Today we are looking at playtime behaviour in the primary school, and you may have noticed some new posters up around the quad and at the back of school reminding us of some of our playground rules, and they are rules that you have suggested yourselves. And so let's have a look at some of those right now.
We wear our hats on the playground. I eat my food before I run off to play. I put my rubbish in the bin.
I wear my mask when I'm not eating. I line up quickly when the bell rings. I drink water to stay hydrated. I let everyone play with my friends and me.
So you may notice there, learners, that here's a rule without a photo, because we're going to be going round the playground, Miss Higgs and I, and we're going to see who's sharing the play equipment with other children. And we can take some photos and make some new posters. And also we're going to go around and see people who are following this rule. I'm always polite to people. So look out for us on the playground and we will think about whether you have any other ideas for playtime expectations.
Let's all follow the playtime rules together.
Let your student counselor know if you think of some other rules that will help us all enjoy playtimes.
We are testing our materials, our baby's diaper.
The material will need to be soft.
The material will need to be soft.
The material will need to be light.
It's dark.
It can't be too tight.
It needs to be waterproof.
The material needs to be waterproof. So do you think this would be a good material for the baby's diaper?
Yeah.
This paper.
Mm-hmm.
You think it would be a good material? Okay.
A diaper is made of something called polymer.
Polymer?
Yeah.
And what does polymer mean?
Polymer is this type of powder that when you add water, it turns into like snow stuff.
Okay, so do you think that will be something that we will need to test when we're looking at our materials for the baby diaper?
So we're going to use this and some tissue. We're going to put it inside. Then we're going to fold it up and then, and we're going to start taking it for the baby.
Do you think these cocktail sticks would be a good material for a diaper?
I don't know.
No,
I don't know.
So what materials are you testing?
We were testing this, so, and this. Testing this, and tissue, and lather.
And what are we going to add to the diaper to see if it's suitable for a baby?
We're
going
to add potion so it can feel soft.
And potion, but then we're going to add water.
It
has to be waterproof. It does.
We were testing our diapers that we made with baby pee, but it was actually just
waterproof.
Were they waterproof?
No.
Were the diapers waterproof?
The diapers were not waterproof.
Were the diapers a good material for the baby? No.
They were hard.
Yeah.
Why is that not good for a baby?
Because otherwise the baby will get cut or get rashes.
Then the next time, if we have something that is like glass that's shaped like a diaper, that's when we blend in the stuff that we used last time and put the comfortable things in. Maybe that would be waterproof.
Some of the diapers were too hard and some of them were too soft.
Next time we can put cotton on the inside of the diaper.
Why?
To make it more comfortable for the baby.
and also for the parents to see the wizard, they know that the baby will be in the diaper.
The outside should be plastic because it will keep the something watery to not come out. It will just stay in.
Can I tell me about your food chain?
So first is the plant, and then the butterfly, and then the bird, and then the flower.
All right, and can you tell me in which habitat this is? Where is this taking place?
This one is taking place like...
Where's this food chain? So we can get in the ocean, or we can be in the desert. Where did you say? In? In the rainforest, Afia. Well done. Thank you, girls.
Here are the learners that have reached their ARP targets. A big well done to them, and they each get themselves house points.
Dr. Frank was one of the maddest people on the entire massive planet. You could recognize him in a millisecond with his enormous lime green goggles, his white coat, and his whitish, blackish, grayish colored hair. His face was as long as a pizza box. Only nobody can't recognize this crazy scientist. Then that day, he was experimenting on a great white shark. He experimented for hours until an enormous mutant shark with legs broke out of the musty old lab and onto the streets. "Wah-ah-ah-ah-ah!" Dr. Frank cackled. The mutant rampaged through the city. General Blackie sends his troops to fight. All the soldiers are either eaten or squashed. "Get Frank here!" screams the general. After a while, Dr. Frank is in the military base getting scolded. "How do we?" Blackie yells. "Take him down!" "We need a nuke to keep in my robot!" demanded Frank. "Fine!" groaned Blackie. A while later, the robot was made. "Since it has a nuke in it, it can blow up the whole city if it's beaten," said Dr. Frank. I'm taking the risk," Blackie announced. The robot fights Mutasaur in the park. The creature takes colossal bites at the bot. The robot blasts it with an uppercut. The mutant gets smashed. The robot is victorious, and the city lives in peace again. The end.
Music can inspire us at any time.
Thank you.